The cost of tariffs is causing dozens of U.S. manufacturers to shift production to countries outside of China. But some of those countries now face threats of tariffs, which could increase prices for American consumers. That's why our next guest says, quote, retail ugly has arrived. Here with us now is American Apparel and Footwear Association CEO and President Rick Helfenbein. It's good to have you here and good to see you again. You say retail ugly has arrived, and yet the latest numbers show that consumer spending has maintained. So what am I missing?
Earnings. Spending is great. Spending is terrific. You know, Prime Day today. What can I say? We're talking numbers on Prime Day that are enormous, 3.8 billion last year, maybe over 5 billion this year. But got to look at retail earnings because the margin compression is going to be brutal. And it's caused by the policies of this administration and where we're being hit with tariffs. You know, the American consumer doesn't like feel it yet, but think about this, 25%, simple math, 25%, 250 billion, that's $475,000 a minute coming out of the economy. And somewhere along the line, it's going to bite the consumer. It's certainly biting on margins because retailers are caught between a rock and a hard place. Do they raise prices? Do they share? Well, what happens to the margin?
Well, you say it sounds like right now they're not raising prices, if I'm hearing you correctly. The margins are getting squeezed. But why not? Why don't they have pricing power when we're looking at an economy that has unemployment where it is, inflation is still relatively low. So why don't your customers feel that they can raise their prices?
Well, they are raising their prices where they can, but the consumer is the one with the ultimate vote. The consumer says, I'm not going to buy it. You know, my favorite thing is I used to walk in downtown Manhattan. There was a guy in the corner. He had 10 T-shirts for $10, and then it was $8. And then it was $6, and now it's 4 T-shirts for $10. He gets it. We're going to sell less. Prices are going to go higher, and it's going to shrink. There's just no way around it. And the point with all this is the administration is sending us a signal. They would like us to vacate China. That's the signal we get. But then they're also blocking all the roads out. You know, the other day, Vietnam mm-hmm. was threatened. India has been threatened. You look at the places that we would go. Number one is Vietnam. Number two is India. Number three is Indonesia, Bangladesh, and Mexico. All have been under some sort of threat. So what are my retailers doing now? They're starting to throw their hands up in the air and say, you know, maybe I'll just tough it out in China.
What they're not doing is bringing it back to the U.S., right? And that's what's so interesting. If the administration's aim was to get Made in the USA back being mainstream for retailers, why aren't we seeing that? What are the obstacles to that happening?
You know what? That is such a good question. We would love to bring it back to the U.S. We can't. We can't. The USA right now is about 2.8% of production in our industry. We've gotten it up to 3. We've eked it up to 3. We don't have the factories. We don't have the workers. We don't have the ability to do it. We would love to do it, but we can't. Mm-hmm. So unless everybody in America is going to be walking around naked, we're going to have to go somewhere else to get the clothes.
An image we don't need. But let me ask you this. When you say retail ugly, we'll start seeing it in the earnings reports.
Yes.
This is the earnings season. When, for the consumer, are we going to start noticing, do you think? Can you give us a timeline when we say, wait, that's much more expensive than I'm used to paying? When are we going to start registering that at the register?
Well, clearly for back to school, which is in our jargon a selling season. And, you know, it's interesting. This morning you're talking about the China GDP and the second quarter. Truthfully, April and May are weak months for shipping. And June is not. That's when you start shipping back to school. So where it could be a quarterly decline, overall, still a lot of goods coming in. And they are raising prices. And you will see it in the back to school season. For sure you're going to see it in the holiday season. There's no way around it. And it's going to create this scenario, which unfortunately I call retail ugly. You can't make your numbers. It's impossible. You're either going to sell less or you're going to have to charge dramatically more. And, you know, in the retail world, we use this thing called IMU, EMU, initial markup, ending markup. We've managed so far to skirt disaster, but we're running out of tools in our toolbox. Plus, when you go to these other countries, they're not, you know, like stupid. They're all raising their prices because demand is exceeding supply. So no matter which way we turn, up, 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 and then sales go down, 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 and you know what the result's going to be.
Rick Helfenbein is the CEO and president of the American Apparel and Footwear Association. Thank you for joining us.